Chris Sakalaris.
Good evening. On behalf of the Hast School Board, welcome to the class of 2017. This class is very special and marks a milestone in that it represents our first cohort of graduates that began here at Hast 7 years ago when we first opened our doors. So not only is it a special night for you, but it's a special night for all of the Hast family. While tonight is about the graduates, I would like to remind each of you that you did not get to this place or this time alone. Your parents, your grandparents, your siblings, your extended family, your teachers, and your friends all helped you along the way. So graduates, please join me in thanking all of those who stood by you and helped you to develop into the extraordinary people that you have become. Finally, to the graduates of 2017, tonight is about celebrating all that you have accomplished and to look forward to writing the next chapters of your lives. Just as you did as students here, continue to reach for the stars and make your mark in the world. In the words of Dr. Seuss, go way back now, congratulations, today is your day. You're off to great places, you're off and away. Congratulations, class of 2017.
As class sponsors, we chose two students who we believe embody the Hast spirit to give student representative speeches. Our first student speaker has been with Hast since that very first day, 7 years ago, September 8th, 2010. He's graduating with a 3.65 and will attend IUB in the fall. He was also the only sixth grader to get a perfect score on every single science quiz and test and earn the coveted Science Streaker gift bag. It is my pleasure to introduce Jose Angel Ringel.
So first and foremost, I want to give all the glory back to God and say thank God for letting me make it here. And I'd like to say thank you to everybody, you know, or my teachers for giving me the chance to speak here at graduation. It's an honor to speak in front of so many people that I myself regard so highly and that are many of whom are my good friends. I would like to personally congratulate all of our graduating class. And I would especially like to congratulate those students who aren't the first in their families to make it through high school and who those themselves never thought they would have made it through. So congratulations. So I myself have grown up with so many of our graduating class. From being at our old building where we had classes in trailers and we were all jammed into a tiny hallway during passing periods to being in our new great huge building. And I have so many memories with almost everybody here. I met lifelong friends. I remember at the end of every year, we'd have a big water balloon fight. And I believe it was my freshman year where Dr. Egan took my water gun and I didn't get back till this year. So this is why it's such a bittersweet moment, because I'm gonna have to admit, I'm gonna be sad to not see all of you every day. So Hast has always been so tight-knit for all of us. Many of us consider ourselves a family. We've all been here to support each other and to listen to each other always. Teachers often seem like friends as they seem to genuinely care about what's happening in our lives. Students at Hast have had a chance to grow into who they really are. I've watched the quietest people become some of the funniest people I've ever met in my life. I know everyone here is gonna go on to accomplish such great things in their life. Growing up with all of you guys, I know how capable Hast made us. We're all go-getters who chase our dreams. Leonardo da Vinci once said, "It had long since come to my attention that people of accomplishment rarely sat back and let things happen to them. They went out and happened to things." This is exactly what we have to do. As the next generation of high school graduates, it is our responsibility to go make something of our lives. We all have to keep this hunger inside of us alive. We have to go after what we want with everything that we have. I see this insatiable hunger in almost everyone here, and this is going to lead us to accomplish whatever we want to do. There's no doubt in my mind that there's going to be hard times in this quest that all of us are undergoing for success. Ali Reisman said, "You have to remember that the hard days are what make you stronger. The bad days make you realize what a good day is. If you never had any bad days, you would never have that sense of accomplishment. Hard times give us perspective. When we're struggling, it's only going to make us into more capable members of society. There's a strength here in each of us. And when we finally make it to where we want to be in life, whether it be having our dream house, dream job, or dream family, the knowledge that we work to get there is going to make it much sweeter. I would like to close by thanking my parents, who without them pushing me, I would have never made it here. My parents never gave up on me and always believed I could do anything. I love you, Mom and Dad. And I want to say thank you to all the parents who supported each of our graduates here as you pushed us all to do great. And to the other graduates, it's our job to make them proud. Let's go out and do something with our lives. I'll miss you guys and love all of you."
Our second student speaker is a brilliant student who is attending Purdue University Northwest to study biology, where eventually she'd like to be a physical therapist. She received the 21st Century Scholarship and College Bound. The scholarship she has received will cover all of her finances, so when she leaves college, she will leave so debt-free. I am very proud to introduce our quiet storm of the senior class, Miss Selena Canuto.
Hi everyone. Okay. I feel like this day could not have come any faster. Then again, preparing for final exams and taking them made me feel like it should have. Although most of us are probably depleted mentally, I'm sure every single graduate sitting in front of me couldn't feel happier to be here today. And we should be. Today is a day to acknowledge our academic successes and to celebrate them with our friends and family. So I would like to take another moment to say congratulations to my graduating class. Four years ago, I stood on the stage to give a speech at our eighth grade graduation. I don't remember much about it, except that my legs were shaking and that I felt a mix of relief, excitement, and uncertainty. Even though I knew we were only moving a floor up, I couldn't help but wonder what high school was going to be like and what kind of people all of us would become. And now, as I stand at Hammond Academy's door, I can see how it molded each graduate before me into determined, hardworking, and compassionate individuals. These qualities are something we should continue to exercise no matter how great our struggles will become, because it is the reason we are receiving our diplomas today. After being here for so long, it is a little difficult to move on. I've never been good at saying goodbye, especially to the people I've become so accustomed to seeing and working with these past five school years. Our time here has allowed us to make many memories, like the last lock-in we had during eighth grade and the DC trip that many of you guys went on. When we learned more about dialysis, Gage, and Sam's Club than we ever did about geometry sophomore year. Or junior year, when we went to Chicago and raced around the city to win a contest, and the one group in particular who was still very upset about the result. And finally, our senior year. For me, it has been the most memorable of all. As teachers of the original sixth grade class, Ms. Burke and Ms. Perjovic have put all their time and effort into making our last year here special and have succeeded. Our senior committee has also worked with them diligently, and I find it very fitting as most of that group has been here also since sixth grade. I've come to know more of you this year and have had many opportunities that I will always be grateful for. So I would like to say thank you. Thank you to my classmates. When I got here in eighth grade, I didn't even know where to begin. I was lost in a new building, knowing only one person. Now I'm friends with all of you and I'm really proud to say that. As we move on in life, I think it's important for us to remember what drives us and to never give way to intimidation. Walt Disney once said, "If you can dream it, you can do it." Problems will always arise, and as Krista infamously said, we can't always use natural logarithms to solve them. You can only strive and fight for what will make you happy, no matter what it is. Don't let anybody take away your definition of happiness, because it is our job and it is our right to pursue it. Thank you to Mario Arroyo. You have left your mark on the school and on every person you've met. We all would have loved to see you here with us today. We will always cherish your memory as someone so full of life and positive energy, and you will always be considered as a part of our family here at Hammond Academy. Thank you to the entire staff. I know almost all of you and have seen nothing other than compassion and dedication to the students and to the school. You guys come in every single day, and some even working well into the evening. Your job isn't easy by any means, but it is inspiring, it is building. The brilliant minds here are a reflection and a result of your care and your work combined. I hope that we made each and every single one of you proud. And lastly, a special thank you to parents and to family. You have been our greatest supporters our entire lives, and I think each of us are more than happy to represent you here today. Your love, although tough at times, has been unconditional because you only want the best for us. We owe so much gratitude to you for getting us to this point and for helping us in our next step in life. Many parents here have also supported the school for the 7 years it's been open, and it's truly a blessing. Your decision to send us here has allowed the school a strong foundation, one that I hope will continue to support future generations to come. No matter where we all go, all of us are destined to do something great in our lives, whether it's going off to change the world or changing a single person's life for the better. I still feel the same uncertainty I did as an eighth grader, and I imagine that some of you guys do as well. It's okay if you're still trying to figure out what you want to do after you leave, because many of the greatest things in life aren't planned. They simply happen. I wish every graduate in front of me the best in luck of what they do. I love you guys. Thank you.
Our next two speeches are our students who finished first and second in the graduating class. Only 0.03 of a point separated them. And this is pretty fitting since only 1 minute separated them from birth. The last 3 years of this particular student bullying me about John Proctor has really changed my life as a teacher. He is graduating with a 4.14 GPA as our salutatorian. Which is amazing. He has received the coveted Chancellor Scholarship, which covers full tuition and fees at Purdue University Northwest, where he'll study electrical engineering. Please help me welcome the firstborn Price brother, Joshua Price.
Hello, everyone. Thank you for being here this evening. Well, no one informed me that I would have to actually make a speech, so let's just have a moment of silence dedicated to our good times. All right, just kidding. I just wanted to see Mr. Jovic's reaction. Okay, first of all, I'd just like to say that time really does go by way too fast. I can still remember being in elementary school. My family was worried about sending my brother and I to a good middle school and high school in the area. We were searching for the perfect place, a place that would help us to not only increase our knowledge, but to help us learn and grow as people. We found Hast instead. Just kidding. I've always heard that the next step of my life would be harder than the previous. As it turns out, that was a lie because it just ended up being more fun. I can't count the times that my friends and I were laughing to where we couldn't breathe, or all the projects where we were able to complete something amazing and have fun doing it. More importantly, I will miss making fun of literally every piece of literature we've ever read in Ms. Burke's English classes. But most importantly, I will miss the countless friends I have made as we continue our journey through life. I'm also happy to say that some of my friends will be attending Purdue Northwest with me. Now, I've been told by all of my teachers that college will be much more difficult than high school, which just obviously means it'll be more fun, right? Just kidding, I'm terrified. So if you ever, just to let you know, if you ever feel like the next step of your life is going to be too hard, or if you think that you can't do it, just remember that every big step in your life so far has been just as difficult. The only difference is that our next steps have direct results, which makes it even more important to do the right thing the first time around. All of these things we're doing now, and everything we will be doing in the near future, they're just going to build our reputations. Our names are going to be associated with our accomplishments and our achievements. And when opportunities arise, the first thing people get to know about you is your name. I personally strive to have many achievements related to my name, like so many others over here today. But why would I want to build my reputation? Why do I want to associate myself with something so useful? To quote the immortal John Proctor from The Crucible, because it is my name, because I cannot have another in my life. I would just like us all to realize that at this point, we all have a high school education associated with our name, so please give us a round of applause for this achievement. And on another note, I'm also very, very proud to have been the grand champion, even if it was just 6 months. I got to host some pretty nice fundraisers, I got to spend time with my friends, and I even got to make new ones. Finally, I want to thank everyone in my life for helping me get through high school. Literally every member of the class of 2017, my brother Jacob, my mom, my Aunt Teresa, and Gran. Hi guys, all the way in the back. Even my neighbor Luella is here today, so round of applause. Woo! Without you guys always pushing me to do my best, and I mean always, I wouldn't be the salutatorian and I wouldn't be giving this speech right now. Thank you for everything that you've done for me. I appreciate and love you all so much. And just one more thing. This is a question for Dr. Ingham specifically. Who decided that the reward for being one of the top students was yet another speech to write? Oh, and Ms. Burke, just one more time. This is worth points, right? All right, guys, thanks for listening.
And now for the right prize. Sorry. What else can I say about this guy? GPA of 4.17, recipient of the Chancellor Scholarship at Purdue University Northwest, the Tri Kappa Scholarship, and the PBA Bowling Scholarship. I didn't even know that existed. In the fall, he'll be attending Purdue University Northwest, where he will study elementary education with a special needs concentration. He then plans on pursuing a master's degree in mental health counseling. However, his finest work has to be playing the part of Bofa opposite Diamond Howard's La Fonda in the dramatic interpretation of the Fourth Amendment. Please welcome valedictorian of this year, Mr. Jacob Price.
Good afternoon. Before I begin, I would like to thank a few people. First, I would like to thank my squad for all their love and support. You know who you are. Without you guys, I would not have the confidence to come up here and give this very speech. Through you guys, I learned how to be more social and stay motivated through these 4 years, and I'm grateful to say I will cherish all the great memories that we created together. This may be a time of parting ways, but I hold my head high and smile because I know that the friendships I have made with this group of people will not be severed. Words cannot describe how important you all are to me and my current successes, and looking back on my experiences here, I would not change it for the world. Just know that if you are ever in need, you can always look to me and I'll always be there to support you. I just hope that the road doesn't end here for the bonds that we created. The next people I would like to thank are the three women who have raised me to be the capable person I am today. These women are my mother, aunt, and grandmother. When words like devotion, love, and resilience come to mind, these women fully exhibit these qualities, and without them, I would be nothing. The sacrifices that these women make daily pushes me to make them proud, and every day I feel like I'll never be able to repay them. I know it wasn't easy for you three to raise two children, but just know it was all worth it. I feel blessed to have you in my life, and the result of your undying love and support is standing before you today. You three mean the world to me, and I vow to take care of you like you have taken care of me. Of Josh and I throughout the years, I love you three with my heart, and without you, I would not be able to be in a strong position to be as successful as I am today. The last and most important person I would like to thank is the salutatory and Joshua Price. Not everyone gets the honor of saying that they have a twin, and I feel like I'm happy to have you in my life. Having you by my side all of these years has taught me to give it my all in everything I do. Our competitive relationship has brought forth a sense of confidence in me, and I feel like I'm capable of accomplishing anything. Although we bicker a lot, nothing can break the bond that me and you have created throughout our lifetime. You're always there when I need you, and you have not disappointed me once. I need a moment. You are always there when I need you, and you have not disappointed me once. In these next stages of life, I fear that we will go our separate ways, but I know that we will always be connected no matter what path we choose. Just know that I appreciate you every single day, and that without you, I would not be as determined as I am right now. I know I don't tell you this a lot, but I love you, and I will be there whenever you need me. Please welcome me in applauding all of these people that are credited for my success. It is an absolute honor to be up here speaking to you all today. I always dreamt that one day I would be standing up here on this stage and giving this speech. What I didn't know was how nervous and overwhelming this would be. Even right now, I'm furiously shaking and eager to sit down. But looking out at this great graduating class and all the supporting families and friends has built up my confidence. We have come a long way from our time at Siena in sixth grade. Not everyone gets to say that I got a great education from a trailer in the back. We learned how to be optimistic, show pride, and most importantly, be a family. Whether it was that cramped single hallway in Siena or this very school, we all had some type of impact on each other. It wasn't an easy transition from being at one hallway church to this school, but it was possible, and it did happen. What made the transition and experience so much smoother was the people that moved with the school. We developed a sense of companionship and loyalty with each other, and being able to be a part of that has strengthened each and every one of us sitting here today. I look around at my fellow graduates today, and I can see the drive in your eyes to make something out of yourselves. I believe that you all can achieve this goal. Today we are graduating, but like our short 4 years of high school, what makes life so valuable is that it doesn't last forever. Like the late Muhammad Ali said, "Don't count the days, make the days count." However you choose to live your life, make sure you're the one happy with the person you become. Don't shape yourself based on someone else's expectations. Lead your own path. That's what life is all about. This high school experience has enabled us to become the people who we want to be. There was never any judgment or criticism when people told their dreams and aspirations. That is what makes our class so unique. We are diverse and open-minded. In this day and age, we need some of this to rub off on society. Starting your life after today is no doubt going to be a challenge. But what you have to remember is to have hope. No matter how bad life gets, you can depend on the people in this room to get past your struggles. As far as support systems go, you all have access to the greatest one, us. We may go our separate ways, but believe me, this isn't the end of the road for us. Sure, we all may be headed in very different directions, but that will never take away from the memories and bonds that we've created here. We need to hold on to each other, because at the end of the day, The only people that really know who you are the people you spent this time with. Thank you for your time and good luck in your future endeavors. I'll miss each and every one of you dearly.
Our next speaker really loves school, so much so that his degrees include a bachelor's in international studies, a master's in education curriculum and instruction, a master's in business administration from Notre Dame, and a doctorate in education. He speaks 11 languages, 4 fluently. He's traveled to 90 countries across 7 continents, from Africa to Antarctica, but his favorite place has to be right here. From entertaining diplomats and lawmakers, or camping with 87 sixth graders, to directing traffic every day after school. Please help me welcome our Zen master and fearless leader from that very first day, Dr. Sean Egan.
I have been here so long that I now need glasses. Honored guests and friends, members of our school board, staff, and students of the Hast family, the Hammond Academy of Science and Technology class of 2017 knows that they hold a very special place in our school's young history and in my heart. In the next few minutes, I will tell you the story once again from my perspective. On a bright fall morning in September 2010, more than 50% of the graduates in front of us stood outside of St. Catherine of Siena, waiting to enter their sixth grade year in a school in a trial run, with staff from all over the region, housed in an old building where we had community meetings in the church sanctuary and ate lunch in silence on days when there was a funeral taking place on the other side of the wall. Remember how you all lined the sidewalks greeting the dignitaries for the opening ceremony? We had a huge lawn for recess, but a narrow hallway for passing periods, and a multi-purpose room divided into quadrants with shower curtains to create an art room, a gym space, and a cafeteria. Then these same young people had another fresh start as part of the student body that entered this present building in 2011. How many kids get to say that they started at a new school, let alone the same new school 2 years in a row? You do. That was then, this is now. I've had so many quality moments with nearly each and every one of you, either in my office, at your lunch tables, in the hallways, and in your classrooms. Never have I walked up to one of you with the question, "Tell me what you're learning," that you have not been able to give me a very complete answer, usually using state standards language, along with the practical applications and uses, as well as your personal critique of the content and the teacher's method of delivery and instruction. So many of you have shared your sorrows, your joys, your worries, and your successes. Family troubles, personal troubles, academic car troubles. You've not held back. You've welcomed me into your universe, and I'm a better person because of this. With few exceptions, you all have an intense passion and pride for this school that might even be stronger than my own. You live and breathe Hammond Academy. Some of you have gone so far as to tell me that you're not quite sure what you're going to do when you're no longer here. Well, guess what? You might be walking out those doors, but they will always be open to you. You will always have your allies here, people who want you to continue to share your lives with us. We are a family. That's what families do. We move around, we fight, we change jobs, we change schools, but we don't lose each other. At this point, I want to share with you some of the characteristics of this class that I will miss the most. Angel and Aya, you greet me every morning with "¿Cómo estás?" and a handshake. Isis, you say hello to me with such respect each and every time that you see me. Selena, you are always so sincere. Aaliyah, you are a fierce and loyal friend to others. Haziel, who will dance down the hallways after you leave? Gideon, who will write me personal notes laced with such passion for justice and fairness? Shelly, who will remember to wish me happy Rosh Hashanah or good Pesach? Shekinah, you are blessed with faith stronger than any mountain. Gerardo and Jaquan, you have both taught me that anything is possible and everyone deserves a chance and some tender loving care. Kim, you are new to our school this year, yet you grace us with beautiful art and a beautiful smile. Justin, oh my God. You always have to say it like it is, no matter what it is. Tanya, you have a voice. Diamond and David, there is no job too small or too large that you can't handle, and you never complain. Joe, you look down on me because you're way taller than I am. Watts, energy and determination, that's all I gotta say. Alize, you are true to yourself always. Price Brothers, it is possible to be competitive and compassionate. Aaron, quiet joker meets hard worker. Who knew the two could coexist so well within one body? Lucas Homko, I'm calling you out just because you asked me to. If your name was not mentioned, trust me, it's not because there's not something or a lot of things that I could say about each of you. In fact, I've got all the pages of my notes on each of you under the chair. You are not a number at Hast. You are a person, and we know you well. After this, you'll be going off in multiple directions: ISU, IUN, IUB, Valparaiso University, IUPUI, Ivy Tech, PNW, Purdue West Lafayette, Cardinal State, Illinois Central, Ancilla College, Jackson State University, Northeastern Illinois University, Indiana National Guard, U.S. Army, and U.S. Marines. A few of you have decided that you want to enter the workforce immediately, and just a very few of you really don't have any idea what is next. And that's okay. You've still got time to figure out what you want to be when you grow up. As a group, and largely thanks to the work of your lovely and amazing guidance counselors, you have earned nearly $1.5 million in scholarships, and that doesn't count 21st century or college-bound scholarships. Wow. Over one-third of you are graduating today with academic honors and or technical honors. Again, wow. These are no small feats. You have earned what you deserve. As I mentioned at the beginning of the speech, nearly 50% of you have been with us since sixth grade. At some point, I told you we'd do something special for those of you who spent 7 years at Hast. While you did not remind me of this, you did remind your teachers, who in turn reminded me. So to mark yet another first, namely those of you who are the first to spend 7 years at Hast, we will be honoring you with a special medallion that will, I hope, become yet another Hast tradition. Wear it and display it with pride. Hammond Academy of Science Technology 7, the Special Award. In closing, I thank your parents and our staff for being your supports and your guides. More importantly, I thank you, the Hast graduates of 2017, for being a phenomenal group of individuals. Your Hast family wishes you all the best as you transition to the next phase of your life, wherever that may be. As my best friend Lisa says, I love you and I like you. Congratulations.
And now the moment we've all been waiting for, the handing out of the diplomas. At most schools, you're asked to remain silent until all of the names have been called. However, Hast is nothing like other schools. We believe each one of these students has worked incredibly hard to be here today, and they deserve all of the noise that we can muster. Jacob Albert Price. Joshua Allen Price. Krista Serena Serratos. Lucas Homko. Luke Vincent Karras. Hannah Lee Watts. Esmeralda Acevedo. Tiffany Aguero. Shelly Gervitz. Selena Canuto.
Great speech. Congratulations.
Angel Daniel Anaya. Kimberly Avila. Elize Cristel Banda Pena. Bella Bocanegra. Lyric Nicole Clapton. Tandy Essence. Aaliyah Cologne. Gideon Kamans. Andrew Michael Condes. Noel Covington. Tanya Cuevas. Gabriela Diaz. James Lewis Gauss IV. Michael Gonzalez. Joseph Haney. Shekinah Chantel Hardy.
I won't mess up your hair. Good job.
Matthew Hatfield.
Good job. Way to go.
Destiny Henning. Michelangelo Howard. Mirena Marisol Hurtado. Amalia Alejandra Igartua. Destiny James. The famous BK, also known as Brian Johnson. Matthew Keel. Robert Daniel Kitchell. Aaron Rayshon Lee. Nicole Lindemann. Damaris Medina. Ariana Christina Muniz. Gerardo Munoz. Adrian Navarez. Yvette Ella Ojeda. David Elias Olivares. Yesenia Giselle Ortiz. Jacob Oviedo. Danielle Nicole Padgett. Alexia Anaí Perez. Armand Polk. Jose Angel Rangel Jr. And so it ends where we begin.
To quote Mrs. Debbie Fenno, seniors, if you can hear me clap once.
If you can hear me clap twice.
If you can hear me clap three times.
All right. Dear graduates, you walked into this gym as Hasterized high school students, and in just a few short moments, you're going to walk out as high school graduates. As your teachers, we're hoping that we've done enough to prepare you. As a small school, we don't have a lot of the extra bells and whistles some of the bigger schools have. But we believe what you've learned at Hast goes beyond normal state standards. At Hast, you've learned
how to make and defend an argument in a debate,
the importance of an election and how every vote matters,
the events of the Salem witch trial and the power of mass hysteria,
how to dine with presidents. Remember, the soup spoon is ladled away.
It's ladled away. How to build a utopian society out of toilet paper rolls and duct tape.
How to navigate a submarine and find an underwater volcano.
I love that. How to write 18,400 note cards for just one genome science class.
This one. How to pitch an original idea in front of a group of local business sharks.
How to raise a flag with 48 steps in the Rube Goldberg Project.
Oh, how to dodge a basketball gracefully while having lunch.
How to walk in a silent straight line with 85 of your peers when there's a funeral next door.
How to critique the student handbook and find every conceivable loophole in the dress code policy to use in an argument with administration. Everyone.
How to leave music class in the basement, go to your locker, go to the bathroom, and be in your seat all in 3 minutes.
You've learned your individual civil rights and liberties and how important they are to protect, no matter your income, gender, race, religion, sexual orientation, or nationality. From your very first class at Hast, you've learned to work and collaborate with others, think outside the box, solve real-world problems, and present and defend your work in front of an audience. So if anyone ever tells you no, or you're not good enough, you can reply, yes, I can, and yes, I am. We're hoping you've learned how to use your voice to make a difference, your brain to make a decision, and your heart to always, always make the world a better place.
We're hoping you've learned enough from us to aid us in whatever life throws your way, but we've also learned a lot from you. You've taught us
the true meaning and fierce loyalty that comes of friendship. It means never forgetting those that knew you when. How lucky everyone in the world would be to have a friend like Diamond Howard, Jose Rangel, or Luke Karras.
True. The power of positivity. Casio Rojas is dancing with the speaker in his backpack. Sorry, Shekinah. And his sombrero and telenovelas he brought to English class. Joe Haney's sunny
good morning, Miss Prajovic,
that he gives every single day. And of course, the Joe Haney. Yeah.
The calming presence of Josh Taylor, Michael Howard, and Selena Canuto.
Lucas Hunko and Josh Price taught us how to fight like champions and remain best friends at the end of the day.
Gideon Kamans taught us there can be passion in everything, even a high-speed rail line.
The importance of apologizing when you've made a mistake, Jordan Roberts.
How to face unimaginable tragedy with grace and dignity after the sudden passing of a beloved classmate. Led by Justin Saavedra, Hast students came together to not only mourn their friend, but also to organize a memorial where they could honor him and create an annual blood drive to keep his legacy alive. We felt your pain and learned it was okay to cry.
Feeling blessed and the power of believing in oneself that exists in Shekinah Hardy, Jacob Oviedo, and Shelly Gervitz.
teaching us words like glow up and lit. Senior committee, hopefully this ceremony lives up to your lit standards.
How to laugh at ourselves and not take everything so seriously, like Noel Covington, Destiny James, and of course our very own famous BK, Brian Johnson.
How a smile can make all the difference in the world, James Gauss and Matthew Keel.
And David Olivares, one-upping everyone, including us, with his unrelenting school spirit.
I'm looking down at your faces, and I'm seeing some of the same faces I saw 7 years ago when I walked into Hast, a new teacher. At this time, can I ask the original Siena students to please rise so I can see your face again? You all took a chance on a brand new idea. See, a group of brainiacs came together and cooked up an idea for a different kind of school. On paper, it all looked good, but would it really work? Well, you and your families came. You believed, you stayed, and you made this school your home. You also made a brand new terrified teacher feel special and loved and important. And I began to believe as well with you. Together, we believed what was happening at Hast was more than just learning. It was a movement. And for that, I thank you. There will forever be a special place in my heart for all of you. But with a new school came a few challenges. A brand new building to break in, teachers leaving during the school year, policies being adopted and then changing. You met all of these challenges together as a unified group. You showed patience and perseverance. You learned the value of hard work and working with others. You will need these qualities as you move forward in the individual paths that you've chosen. Hast has given you a good start, but you're not finished. Now the real work begins. Make your plans, chase your dreams, but whatever you decide, don't stop. Don't ever stop moving forward. And if you ever get stuck, remember where you came from. Remember that at one time you were fearless. All it takes is one step forward. Graduates, look to the person to your left. Now look to the person to your right. You have broken all high school statistics. You've silenced the critics. You've all made it. Now you just have to take that one step forward. Graduates, move your tassel to the left.
Ladies and gentlemen, we now present to you
the Hast Class of 2017!